My second full day in northern Germany was spent exploring the vast estate and castle of Schloss Gottorp, or Gottorp Castle, in the city of Schleswig-Holstein, situated on an island in the Schlei, a narrow inlet stretching for about 20 miles from the Baltic Sea to the city of Schleswig. Schloss Gottorp is the ancestral home of the Holstein-Gottorp branch of the Danish House of Oldenburg. The Danish Duke of Schleswig purchased the estate from a bishop in 1268, and in 1340 it was transferred to the Count of Holstein of the House of Schauenburg. It took 50 years, starting in 1947, to renovate the estate, and the palace is now owned by a foundation of the state of Schleswig-Holstein and houses the State Art and Cultural History Museum and the State Archaeological Museum. In the former stables of the castle was an exhibit of German-Danish painter Emil Nolde, who changed his name from Hansen in 1902 and took the name of Nolde, a village in North Schleswig. Known for his brushwork and expressive choice of colors, Nolde was a painter I admired in college and was one of the first expressionists and painters of the early 20th century to explore color. I was required to check my camera, so I purchased this book as my takeaway. The outstanding Baroque terraced garden called Neuwerkgarten, located on palace grounds, showcases a replica completed in 2005 of the original Gottorfer giant globe, a walk-in globe now located in the Kunstkammer in St. Petersburg. This early Baroque garden was to enter the history of the country as the first terraced garden north of the Alps. Today, the Gottorfer Neuwerkgarten is the only freely accessible Baroque garden in Schleswig-Holstein preserved in its original form. The Neuwerkgarten was the youngest of the three original gardens surrounding the castle. The beginning of the 17th century ushered in the early Baroque style, characterized by the attempt to observe and explain phenomena in nature more and more independently of the ecclesiastical worldview. The plants and animals, weather and stars, released from their holistic divine context, met with great interest. Frederick III was devoted to science, especially botany. He had the Neuwerkgarten planted primarily for scientific purposes. First, the so-called Herculean pond and a higher terrace were built on the ground floor of the garden. In 1660, the garden was extended by four more terraces to the north. On the highest terrace, an orangery for the wintering of frost-sensitive tropical fruits. Not only was the globe a sensation, but also the spectacular variety of plants that Duke Frederick had brought to his garden. Among them were various types of tulips, hyacinths, and daffodils, as well as exotic species such as pineapples, aloes, and citrus plants. In the 18th century, the former magnificent garden was abandoned to growing decline. The imposing flower beds and elaborately cut hedges were overgrown, while wells and cascades were exposed to weathering. When, in the middle of the 19th century, Schloss Gottorp was used as a barracks, riding grounds were created on the terraces of the Neuwerk. It is astonishing that of the more than 1,000 plant species, despite long neglect, some 20 have survived to this day. They formed the basis for the later replanting. 1984 began the successive large-scale restoration of the garden. With the inauguration of the new Globe House and the reconstruction of the Gottorp Globe, the entire Neuwerk Garten has returned to its former glory. The tour of the permanent exhibition on art and cultural history begins in the Gothic Hall with a collection of medieval altars and religious sculptures. In the West Wing, from the mid-16th century, visitors encounter numerous paintings by Dutch Renaissance masters and works by Lucas Cranach the Elder. The Gutenberg Bible, which was written between 1452 and 1455, is one of the outstanding pieces in the spiritual treasury. The castle chapel of 1590, where Branca and her children were baptized, was always used as a church, despite the changing history of Gottorp Castle. Today, it is still used by the Danish parish in Slesvig for their church services. The gallery, which runs around three sides, shows a cycle of 28 pictures with scenes from the life of Jesus. According to the Reformation Research Consortium, an international network of research institutions focusing on early modern Christianity, the chapel, with its rich interior in the late Renaissance style, conveys an impression of the grandeur of the castle in its greatest period as a residence for the princes of Schleswig-Holstein-Gottorp. As an early Protestant building for churches in the north, it also reflects in an exemplary fashion the devoutness of the Lutheran Reformation with its accentuation of the example of Christ and the proclamation of his word through sermon and music.
In this chapel in the castle of Schleswig, I was baptized many years ago, and also my children were baptized here.
There is so much of interest at Schloss Gottorp, and the estate is so vast, I recommend doing a little research before traveling there. We were able to see but a portion of all the richness this historic palace, gardens, and museums have to offer. After a long, fulfilling day, we drove home past quaint cottages, one of which was owned by a beekeeper.